St. Paul's letter to the Galatians talks about freedom, freedom in Christ. To experience this true freedom that Jesus talks about, to have the comfort of this freedom and this peace that comes with it, the more that I grow in holiness, the more that I go on my Christian journey, the more that I am convinced that there is one thing, one hurdle, just one hurdle that we need to get over before we can experience this freedom that Jesus talks about. One hurdle. Now, for those of you that journal, you might want to get your journals out. You might want to write this down. Yourselves. Yes, it's true. If we want to experience this freedom, we must get over ourselves, because our pride and our selfishness is the one thing that's getting in the way of us experience that true freedom in Christ. Now, when the scriptures talk about freedom, it's more than simply choosing to believe in God. Freedom in Christ comes from the freedom to answer the call, to answer his invitation to live and move and have our being in Christ. That's what true freedom is, when we accept that call. It's important to get over ourselves, because how many times do we say I every day of our lives? When Jesus calls us into himself, when he calls us, it's not so much that we have a freedom not to do what he's calling us to. Gospel freedom really is that freedom to choose what he's calling us to. We really don't have the right or the freedom to choose something else, which is important, which is why it's important to discern the will of the Lord for us. At the beginning of Mass, before we started, I just asked us kind of consciously to put ourselves in the presence of Christ, to accept his invitation so that we can be in his presence and he in ours. It's so important that we do that, because if we don't come with that awareness of accepting the Lord's invitation to be with him, how sad it is that we could come in this church and we could be in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament. Literally, Jesus could be sitting right next to us, and he is, but we wouldn't be open to his grace. In other words, we would actually, by our own intentions and our own misgivings, we could miss his presence here and not be fed and not hear where he is calling us. It's very important that we listen and discern properly. Now, how do we discern what Jesus is calling us to, what God is calling us to in our lives? I often believe that it's important to do that. And as we start accepting the will of God and going down our path of holiness and start serving him, I think a good indicator of whether or not we are serving the Lord properly in the role that he wants us is, are we satisfied doing that? Now, I'm not meaning satisfied by comfortable. I mean, are we fulfilled by doing that? Are we not forcing it? Because serving the Lord really should not come by force. It should come quite naturally, because that's exactly what Jesus has called us into. And we can tell, I think, when we're doing something that the Lord doesn't want us to do, whether it's going down the wrong path in life, whether it's turning to sin or something like that. We know when we're forcing something and it's not working. When we turn to the Lord, it makes it so much easier. I remember when I was discerning priesthood, and I thought, well, maybe someday I'll do that. Maybe some other day I'll do that. The thoughts kept coming back time and time again. And finally, once I said yes, there was no turning back, and it wasn't work. But it's amazing how much tension you can have when you're not really doing what the Lord wants us to do. It's like you're playing that tension, and it takes a lot of energy away from you. Now, in the gospel, this is kind of interesting why it's important to get over ourselves when we accept the will of God and all of that. You notice what happens here. There is one part in this gospel where somebody comes up to him and says, Lord, I will follow you wherever you go. Now, that sounds good. It sounds just like what we want someone to say. But Jesus responds in kind of an interesting way. And he says this, foxes have dens and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head. This comment comes right after someone comes up to him and says, I will follow you wherever you go. You see what's wrong with that little statement of that person? Whenever we accept the Lord of the call of Jesus, we are called first. It is not about us, it is about Jesus. And so when this person goes up and says, I will follow you, Jesus kind of steps back, because it wasn't Jesus that called him into that role that this guy wanted to perform. He wanted to kind of serve on his own terms. And so that's why Jesus goes into a little bit different statement. How many times do we think it's all up to us? It's my choice whether I go to church today. It's my choice whether I get confirmed or not. It's my choice whether I do this or that, or it's my choice. When we forget that, before we can choose anything, Jesus first needs to call us. And once he calls us, we have no choice but to say yes. That's the freedom we have. And that's where the fruits come from, saying yes to the Lord. I don't know about you, but my personality is kind of one that I like to have everything in a row. I like to know well in advance what's going on. And I like to have control on almost everything. That can be a little bit problematic when it comes to serving the Lord, because really, I'm not the one in charge. Jesus is. And the Lord has a way of working through us just by being ourselves. Sometimes we have to get beyond ourselves just to take a little bit of a leap of faith into the Lord and let the Lord to work. Now you notice what happens here. Another one says, he said, after this one, Jesus turns to someone else and says, you follow me. A call that's been given. You follow me. What does the person say? In essence, he says, I have some other things to do first. Let me go take care of a few things other first, then I'll come back. In other words, I have something more important to do. Or I'll serve. You know, the other one says, I will follow you, Lord, but first let me say farewell to my family at home. In other words, I will follow you, I will serve you, but let me do these things too. In other words, let me serve on my own terms. I will serve you so long as I can come to church at 9 o'clock in the morning for Mass. If that would change for some reason or another, would we be willing to serve? It's about giving ourselves to the Lord. Or what about I will serve you so long as I can serve in this way. That never works, you see. We have to give ourselves over to the Lord in order to really, really discern. And when the Lord calls us to serve in a specific way, say yes to that, and good things happen. The Lord helps them, and in the Lord, we do good things. Then what happens here, you know, It's impossible to serve the Lord while being selfish. And once we kind of say yes to the Lord and we start serving the Lord, even sometimes when we're doing the right things, serving him in the right way, what can happen is our pride can still get in the way. And we can start thinking that we are holier or doing something better than someone else. We can start looking at people and start judging them because they're not at the same place that we are spiritually. That can happen very easily when we don't let ourselves, when we don't place our trust in the Lord and know that the Lord works in his own way. If we serve patiently, patience is a virtue. If we don't, as we serve the Lord, we can become like James and John. When we don't see things that we want to see, that we think people should be doing, we could be like James and John and say, Lord, should we call fire down from heaven and consume them? We can get very judgmental at people and sometimes. And Jesus is essentially saying, have patience, trust in the Lord. Simply be yourself. Serve in the way that I've called, and be compassionate and gentle, and live in his message, and live in his truth, live in him. Be compassionate just as Jesus is, and that can go a long way. I was reminded of a story that I've heard recently about a gentleman who goes into a diner, and he sits down next to another guy who's been sitting there for quite some time. And after about 10 minutes, the guy who walked in says, "Gee, maybe they don't know we're here. They haven't come to take our order yet." And the gentleman sitting next to him says, "Well, maybe they didn't see us. Give them a little bit more time." So about 5 minutes passes, and then the gentleman says again, "Gosh, maybe they just don't want our business. Maybe we're not important enough." And the gentleman says, "Well, maybe they're understaffed today. Maybe someone didn't come into work, and maybe that's why they're slow. So just have patience." About another 10 minutes comes, and the guy says again, "You know, I can't take this. I'm going to leave." And the gentleman next to him says, once again, he said, "You don't know what the issue is. Just have patience." Well, about a half an hour passes, and the server comes over and says, "I have to apologize. You see, our dishwasher is out, our cook didn't come in, and I'm doing everything myself today." And at that, the guy who was preaching patience got up and angrily walked out the door. And the guy who was left sitting there thinking, "I really hated what I just saw in him." And he couldn't figure out exactly what it is until he took it to prayer and he thought, "Ah, yes, he was preaching, he was doing what I was preaching." And so it's interesting how we can get all caught up in this, but actually do the wrong thing. We can know exactly what to say. We can say the right things, but when push comes to shove, we can fail miserably. And that example isn't very good. So today, let us pray that we may embrace the freedom in Christ to really choose what he is calling us into, discern well what he is calling us to, and strive each day to get over that hurdle of ourselves and trust in the Lord to live in his peace, because that will serve to convert many people in his name. And let us give thanks to the Lord for the gifts and blessings he's given to us. And as we go through the rest of the Mass today, let us once again consciously, very consciously, invite Jesus into our hearts and into our lives so he can transform us and lead us to truth, and give us that true freedom in him.